Most of us want to look physically attractive and care for our body. Sometimes aggressive steps are also taken individually to look good and be healthy. What about the church? The church is the body, right? Does the church really have a beautiful body? Welcome to today's message based on Titus chapter 2 verses 1 through 8. On the topic, family as the best health supplement. A Russian team discovered seeds, which was a flowering plant native to Siberia, that had been buried by an ice age squirrel near the banks of a river. The dating confirmed that the seeds were 32,000 years old. The team that studied this plant said that this plant grew, flowered, and after a year created seeds of their own. And this was possible because there was life inside the seed and it grew because of the right environment. So even if you are 8 or 80 years old, there is a beauty in your life. While good health is important, the concept of beauty is skin deep is very much relevant and needed to be understood. The relationship of God to His people is exemplified in the Bible through the family. Why are some people in government corrupt? It's because of the values in the family. The family is the prototype of society. If you destroy the family, you destroy the society. Everyone in the family makes up the body of Christ, the young, old, male, and female. In the letter to Titus, the apostle tries to lecture the topic of moral obligations before the world in which they live, that they may have a positive impact on an unbelieving world. Saint Paul focuses on four groups in the church: older men, older women, younger women, younger men. These can be considered as vitamins for a good body. God created the family as an ideal institution. The church is the body or the family of God. And everyone has to give life to this body and play their part. God's design is that we learn to live harmoniously and learn from one another. I'm sure many having older and younger generations have problems and tensions in the church. Some even say that the older generation cannot be taught. The distance between younger wives and older mothers are so much that we rarely see a connection, sometimes even in the family. Titus is encouraged here to make sure he teaches sound, healthy doctrine to God's people and apply it to their lives and be changed by it. It will not be automatically gained by age. Therefore, a check is required to see if the body of the church is healthy. This is totally not about physical beauty and a great deal on what the physical appearance cannot influence. Older men are to be temperate, dignified, self-controlled, sound in faith, in love, and in endurance, as is written in verse 2. This verse is directed toward the senior men in the congregation. They are to be level-headed, cool-spirited, and honorable, having their passions under control. They trust God and wait patiently for the fulfillment of their hope in Christ. Spiritual maturity comes through growing in the grace and knowledge of Christ. Verses 3 to 4, it said, "For older women likewise are to exhibit behavior fitting for those who are holy." A mentoring ministry, that is. God has ordained for women as wives and mothers. The world has demeaned it to a large degree. Christian women are almost ashamed to acknowledge that their primary concern in life is to be a godly wife and mother. Matthew chapter 19 verse 6 says, "What God joins together, let no one separate." The emphasis is whom God joins. It is not an arrangement, it is a covenant. People started accepting, redefining the role of a family, and innocently they become a real part in destroying the kingdom of God. How can you say that you come before God to put together and then go to an advocate for divorce? Divorces are increasing in churches too. And this makes it difficult to preach on this topic by many priests. Couples today hardly give some time to work out their marriage, and they decide for divorce without even allowing the concept of husband and wife settle in. People are ready to get married before the settlement of divorce. This is not God's standard for the family. It is not God's will for a family to fall apart. You destroy the family, you destroy the kingdom of God. The government is supposed to protect what God created. Instead, they have set up many ways to promote the opposite of togetherness and breaking of natural laws. Hence, we can add to the other factors that assert that the government cannot produce a good family. Every person in the church has a role and a purpose. In verses 5 of Titus chapter 2, it said why this is so. So that the message of God may not be discredited. They will not bring shame or dishonor on the word of God. In the Hebrew, the meaning of family extends to household, to your servants and anyone who works for you. So your workers should also possess the same values as your home. Thus, a moral society is formed. An ideal nation is formed. The increase in crimes, rapes, and social evils is because the family itself has lost. If our lifestyle fails to reflect the character of God, then we diffuse our testimony. Dear brothers and sisters, building a Christian home is a vital part of our calling and witness to the world. A family is a place meaning to feel at home and a place you fit. We need to be very conscious inside our families because we have a great responsibility for the work of God in the world that begins with our families. Only then we will have a great nation with less poverty and crime. Therefore, invite God's presence, sanctify the family, and be a responsible member in your family, of your family. Praise the Lord. Thank you for joining today. Until next time, stay safe and well. Bye-bye.